So brand new San Diego Comic-Con 2018 DC pictures have come out from the Shazam movie and the Aquaman movie. And who the heck is this character in this Aquaman photo? We're going to be breaking that down and I'm going to be explaining this in today's video. How's it going, Webheads? My name is Ryan Walsh and welcome to Webhead, where I help you guys keep up to date with all the latest in geek entertainment. I am back, guys. I am finally back, and it's great to be back. And all of yesterday, I was really just going and looking at exactly what I missed, because I literally had my phone off for 7 full days. So I had to go on and really just see everything that I missed. But God, did I miss a lot, because there's a bunch of DC and Marvel that's been really ramping up for San Diego Comic-Con, and I want to talk about all that stuff. I'll be talking about Marvel later on today. But in this video, we're going to be focusing on the Shazam, Aquaman, and just the entire DC panel at San Diego Comic-Con. First, I'm going to get into Shazam, so let's get into it. Well, we first got this image from Entertainment Weekly, and it actually shows Shazam and Billy Batson in this official image. And I gotta say, guys, I really do like what this Shazam movie is looking like. At first, I wasn't that big of a fan of it because I was like, oh, well, Shazam kind of looks like it's gonna be extremely corny and it looks like it's gonna be kind of dumb. And I know a lot of you guys have had mixed reactions on this and really saying that this Shazam costume looks completely crappy. It doesn't look good at all, looks completely fake. And I can't disagree with you guys. When we saw it in the set photos, it definitely looked extremely fake, but there were set photos. Now we're seeing the real thing, how it's gonna look in the movie. And I gotta say, guys, I think it looks awesome. And I think a lot of people are really forgetting the Shazam character. Remember, Billy Batson is Shazam. He's just a 10-year-old kid, and this photo really shows what the movie's going for, really showing that they're doing the true Shazam from the original comic books, showing that when Billy Batson turns into Shazam, he is still a 10-year-old kid, so he's going to act like a 10-year-old, like really silly, and it just makes so much sense. I mean, what would a 10-year-old be when he has godlike powers like Superman or any other superhero? That really just shows you exactly what they're going for, and I think they're really nailing it with the promotional art that we've seen, the poster that came out. I think everything's looking really good, and I'm actually very excited for Shazam. Definitely expect probably a trailer. I'm thinking we're probably going to get a first trailer along with Aquaman, probably at San Diego Comic-Con. Maybe they'll release it to the public. I personally really hope they do, but if we get a description of what it is, I'll probably break it down on this channel with that coming out. And now really moving on to the Aquaman photo that just got released from the San Diego Comic-Con previews, and it shows the Fisherman King from the Aquaman movie. And guys, I just gotta say right off the bat, this Aquaman movie, I am so excited for because of really just this image. It's just showing you exactly what they can actually do with this movie and how amazing it's gonna look. You guys may not be excited for the new DC movies, but guys, I think they're really turning it around. And you gotta admit, right in this picture, they look awesome. These Atlanteans, or whatever you want to call them, but just the characters seeing on screen, they're going to be so cool to actually look at. And James Wan did come out and he basically said that this is mainly practical effects. So that's awesome right there. I think they look fantastic. And really going off of exactly who is the Fisherman King? Who is this guy? Is he actually going to be a big part of the movie? And I think he will be. I think he's going to be playing a lot of a role, just like maybe M'Baku, the man-ape from the Black Panther movie. And now they're going to be transferring it over, and Jason Momoa's Aquaman is going to have the relationship with the Fisherman King. Because in the comic books, if I'm not mistaken, it took a lot of research to find this, but I remember reading in the New 52 Aquaman, someone called the Fisherman, and he wasn't the Fisherman King, but he was like the Fisherman. So I'm thinking, is this Fisherman King actually the same guy in New 52? And everything points to, yeah, that actually is going to be him, but there's also another character from the 60s that actually is called the Fisherman King as well. So obviously he is from the comic books, but I think they're really showing here and what James Wan, the director of Aquaman, actually was going on about and explaining exactly why these guys look more like fishes than Aquaman looks like a human. Why is everybody looking so different? Well, the reason for this is really just about the evolved characters. There will be 7 kingdoms of the sea, and basically they're just different kind of races throughout all the oceans, and all 7 kingdoms really represent something different. So with the Fisherman King and his race is really just one of the kingdoms that actually happened with the fall of Atlantis. When they actually went into the water, some Atlanteans actually evolved, some de-evolved, and some just stayed the same. So saying that this Fisherman King, he evolved. These are the evolved creatures. And then saying the trench creatures from the New 52 comic books, those will definitely be showing up in the Aquaman movie. Those are de-evolved creatures where they just lost their minds and now they're just monsters in the trenches. And then there's Aquaman and all Atlanteans. those are actually just the characters that are just mid-evolved. They basically just kind of stayed the same. They didn't really evolve all that much, but they just became extremely powerful, and now they're able to breathe underwater. That's really the only difference that's going on there. But now moving on to what we actually can expect from the San Diego Comic-Con 2018 DC panel, I think we really can expect Aquaman, Shazam, and Wonder Woman 1984 to be the main movies that we're gonna see in this entire panel. Those are gonna be your main movies. But then we might be getting an appearance from the Joker movie that's set to actually shoot probably within the next couple months. I heard a rumor about that, so that might actually happen. And then the Batman movie, the Matt Reeves Batman movie, is probably gonna be making an appearance as well. But then something that's kind of rumored is really just a Man of Steel 2, Green Lantern Corps, and Flash. There's been news coming out about all three of those movies. Like, Flash is gonna be kind of like Back to the Future. Green Lantern Corps is gonna be written by Geoff Johns, who wrote the comic books. And then Man of Steel 2 has had a bunch of different rumors that it was gonna be happening. I actually think that we're gonna be seeing Superman's next appearance in the Shazam movie, because I think both those characters are very related, and I think Superman would do a great job in that movie, because they're both kind of the similar characters. But Webheads, let me know down in the comments what videos you guys want me to do next. Of course, if you guys want more on DC, definitely consider checking out the playlist below me that I put together for you guys, and definitely consider subscribing right over here to Webhead so you guys get more on the San Diego Comic-Con DC stuff coming out. But Webheads, thank you all very much for watching. I really do appreciate it. Bye-bye.